Coming to you from Portage La Prairie, Manitoba, this is Shaw TV's live coverage of the 2015 Canad Inns Men's Classic here on Shaw TV. This event is part of the World Curling Tour and is proudly sponsored by Canad Inns. Hello, everybody. I'm your host, Mike Valente. We're upstairs here at the Tavern United, part of Canad Inns, overlooking eight beautiful sheets of ice. And we are ready for our final match of the tournament today. It's Team Cooey versus Team Laycock. Team Laycock ranked the number one men's curling team in Saskatchewan. They won a bronze medal at the 2015 Tim Hortons Briar. They will battle Team Cooey, who we saw in action yesterday, originally from Saskatchewan, now residing in Calgary. And for more on tonight's match, here's Mike Beauregard and Kathy Gauthier. Guys?
All right, thanks, Mike. Kathy, our championship final features a former world champion in Kevin Cooey up against an emerging rink in Stephen Laycock's. Your impressions of what we have on the table here?
It'll be a really great game, I've no doubt. For Kevin Cooey, this is not an intact team, of course, that he took to the Worlds, but they are all great champions, Olympians, you name it, that team has won everything. But Steve Laycock, this is not their first year together. They've been together for a couple of years. Last year's Briar performance, very, very impressive. Saw a lot of depth, Dallin Myers, Kirk Myers, really seeing them not only age, but have that experience that you can only get by going through it. And that's helped this team a lot. Only undefeated team in this field.
And it's fair to say, not a prohibitive underdog in this match, despite the fact that, you know, Cooey has won at the top levels. He's won his last two World Curling Tour events early in the season.
No, I mean, they have a lot of respect for each other, but for the Laycock team, having been to the Briar and performed well, done well on the Curling Tour, this is a team that they play over and over. They don't really care what they bring to the table. They're bringing a lot themselves.
All right, there won't be any Manitoba flavor in the final this year. Mike McEwen was bounced yesterday. Reed Crothers went out this morning in the quarterfinals, but we've got a pretty deep field here.
It has been a tremendous field. You know, we heard Kevin Cooey say yesterday that this is one of the toughest fields on the entire tour. And so that's kudos to Portage for sure. You know what? Sorry that Manitoba didn't make it through, but we have some great champions. And Manitoba got pretty close.
Our championship final is next. 18,000 goes to the winning team, 10,000 to the finalist. We're back with the first end in just a moment. You're watching the Canad Inns Men's Classic from Portage on Shaw TV.
Here with Paul Robson, the CEO of Canad Inns. First off, Paul, why has it been so special to keep this tournament here in Portage La Prairie over all these years?
Well, it was about to leave Portage La Prairie, and Canad Inns stepped in. We do business in the community. We're part of the community. It's part of our mission. And so we decided to take over the tournament. And it's been a great success, certainly for us, and a great success for the World Curling Tour. And I think for the city of Portage La Prairie, it's just another one of those things that creates excitement in the city.
The men's event concludes this evening. Obviously, we have the women's next weekend, but in between, we have the mixed doubles.
Yeah, really an interesting situation. Jeff Stoughton came to us and said, look, it's an Olympic sport, and we want to get it started. And we said, well, yeah, why don't we just fit it in between the men's and women's? It's really this way. Canada's expected to win a gold in hockey and curling, and we might as well start now getting ready to win a gold in mixed curling. So anything we could do to help Curl Canada and Jeff Stoughton to put some of this on, we're just delighted to be able to do.
I got to get your thoughts on the final today, Team Cooey versus Team Laycock.
Well, you know, Mike McEwen generally wins this thing every year.
Big surprise, he's not in it.
No,
yes.
He's not in it. But Cooey was the runner-up last year, and I don't have a favorite, it's flip a coin, but we're delighted that we've got a team from Alberta and a team from Saskatchewan, both of whom have been regulars at this tournament, and I hope they've enjoyed themselves, and one of them's going to walk away with a big check.
Thank you very much, Paul, for your time.
Great.
Let's send it upstairs to Mike and Kathy.
All right, thanks, Mike. Kathy, our featured matchup, Team Cooey out of the Glencoe Curling Club in Calgary against Team Laycock out of the Nutana Curling Club in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. And I guess if it isn't McEwen,
Cooey's been knocking at that door. He's actually the only skip to win this event in the last 5 years, other than Mike McEwen winning back in 2012, but he was a finalist last year and always seems to do well here in Portage. Both of these teams, we should mention, heading in red hot. Cooey's team coming off back-to-back victories. They won the Tour Challenge in Newfoundland and last week won the Direct Horizontal Drilling Fall Classic by going 6-0. But the Laycock rink should not be overlooked here. They've made the semifinals in 3 of 4 World Curling Tour events this fall and are the only undefeated team in this event this week.
You know, there's a lot to be said for both of these teams. They certainly both do put a lot of time in on the tour. So watch Dallin throw his first one. It's really interesting, the strategy that Steve is playing in this end with that short guard. You would expect that in the third day of an event, and for these teams having played a minimum of, this is their sixth game in the Laycock case, having gone through undefeated, that he might try to utilize that and go around, but he's going out to the wings.
This turn.
And here's a look at Ben Hebert.
Whoa.
Well, Ben Hebert and Mark Kennedy, longtime members of Kevin Martin's team, Olympians, decided that they were prepared to make the change. Teamed up with Brent Lang, formerly of Glenn Howard's team, and Kevin Cooey for a new look. Certainly one of the things this team never lacked, even from the outset, was that experience factor. Doesn't matter how large the game will be that they will play in together, they're not going to ever find themselves in a circumstances where it's new turf for everybody. And for this team, we talked about that great performance, the bronze medal at the Brier last year. And I think sometimes you get to a bronze medal and you've fought all week to get there. I kind of felt that this was a team that gained momentum and teams were really concerned about playing them, especially late in the week. And so it's great to see them staying intact and coming back to see if they can repeat that performance out of Saskatchewan and get their ticket to Ottawa and see what happens there.
That's clean. Whoa. Clean. Whoa. 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 All right, let's go.
Well, we started the day with 8 rinks. Laycock defeated Manitoba's Reed Crothers in the quarterfinals this morning and then took out Charlie Thomas in the semis this afternoon. And conversely, it was Cooey defeating Brendan Botcher and then taking out Brad Jacobs in a heavyweight semifinal this afternoon.
And that really is indicative of that field that we talked about earlier, Mike. It's just such a strong field. Not a lot of free space or easy teams to play.
Good hack.
One of the problems for Steve Laycock is that that guard is so tight to the house that even if he were to have rolled completely behind, that straight back was there and would have left it buried. For Brent Lang trying to play that hit and roll in, just solid quiet hack. Weight to get the movement.
Solid hack. No. Clean. No.
And a good chance to see what the ice does. We did this yesterday, and of course there were more teams out there. But now that we're down to a single sheet, sometimes you do see the ice conditions change a little bit. Teams were allowed to choose stones for this game. So would utilize those that they'd thrown before, that they felt comfortable with, that they knew what they did. But the ice is not always the same. It's a pretty straight path.
Board.
Colton may have thrown a little bit more than Steve was looking for.
Mark. Go for it. Yes. Eight.
Yep.
Hard. Go, baby, go.
Go.
Go. Go, 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 go. Keep
going. Sorry, Kev. Skip.
Probably worth a try yet, eh?
And that's just the difference between the two weights. We saw Colton throw quite a bit more than Mark Kennedy did, and the response was dramatically different.
Here's a look at Kirk Myers, the third for Team Laycock. And you're pretty high in his ability.
I am. I am very much. I think that he's very calm in the house, usually offers lots of advice, keeps himself at a very even temperament, and makes a lot of big shots when he needs to. So far in this first end, we're playing find the hit and roll that's perfect. They're all over.
Final stone for Mark Kennedy. Last of the third stones now. Fairly clean house, Kathy, but these two teams are playing like they have a flight to catch or something.
And they, I don't know that they're flying to Saskatchewan. They may just be driving, given where we are. But you know what, it is interesting when you think back to the early part of this end, when the very first stone was thrown short, that is the only guard left in play. And the decision by Steve Laycock to play out to the wings, it is playing an open style with the potential always of utilizing that center guard. And both teams have tried to roll it, have just not found that magic weight that will move over as much as they want it to do.
Kevin Cooey with a record of 7-2 in this event. His foursome has played two more games than Laycock's.
And there we go. Finally, after about eight consecutive shots, found the right combination of ice and weight. And they will get that perfect roll, and that guard out front is also theirs.
That's really different. I think that's what he plays. So what do you want to do here? Just here?
Yeah. Move it an inch.
Yep. Go, bud.
Well, a tough shot for Steve on his very first one, looking to freeze down to that stone. Does need to touch it back a little bit. There is no right turn for this shot. It's whatever you feel will finish more.
Go, bud. T-line.
Looking for T-line weight.
Move it a couple inches. Probably going to be enough. Okay. Okay.
As one of the most precise, methodical pre-shot routines, I have not ever seen him deviate from that, which is important.
off we need to. Yep.
First stone for Laycock. He has the hammer here in the first.
Track
east. Yep. Hard.
Track east.
Hard.
Track cold.
Hard.
Hard.
Whoa. 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 Over.
Well, Leah shot stone, and they worked that hard out of his hand, mostly because of the line issue.
I guess even if I...
We heard out of his hand they were calling, not because it jumped dramatically, just because the movement was such that they needed to go to get by the guard. So there's more separation between that blue and yellow stone than he ideally wanted. But had to be shot, and he is.
Get a curl.
Yeah, he shot deep. He had, what would he had? He would have had a lot of weight.
Could have just kept hitting and rolling back and forth.
Freeze ours? No. Oh yeah, he just draws. I guess you're saying I could corner freeze on this. No, we're way back. Then he just draws down to us.
You like the ice?
Yeah, it looks tough. If I corner freeze with the out turn, is it any good?
Yeah, it's okay.
Can he come to the back one?
Maybe. It's close.
No, I think I can make this.
Okay, just let me know the ice, guys.
I just
let me know the weight.
Enough. Yeah, I just need to get shot. He can't slash it.
Well, the question for Kevin Cooey was, if I come down to the face of the stone, and even if I'm not shot, could Steve Laycock come down to that stone with the outturned side, that's the Cooey stone, and get two? And you heard Mark say potentially. So he is trying to tap the stone back to ensure that he's shot.
Whoa, 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 now. Right off the line. Right off. Curl. Curl.
Stone stayed out much more. I don't know whether Steve got his going on his release or Kevin put his back, but they ran completely different paths with pretty similar weight. We're right off all of the way. Catches it just on the outside. Jams it back, and so an opportunity here in one for Steve Laycock. You heard him say hack weight for the opening deuce.
Last rock, first end. Clean. Steve Laycock with a chance for a first end deuce. A championship final of the Canadiens Men's Classic. Laycock versus Cooey.
On the nose, and there's your two.
The rink from Saskatchewan, Saskatoon to be exact, picks up two in the first end, and they lead former world champion Kevin Cooey 2-0. Lots of curling ahead. And now an interview from Mike Valente. He stopped by and checked in with two-time world champion Jeff Stoughton, who's here this week, but not playing.
Here with three-time Brier champion and two-time world champion Jeff Stoughton. How are you, sir?
I'm doing fine, thank you.
Thank you very much for joining us. What's it like being here at the event, and you're participating in the doubles, which starts tomorrow?
Yeah, I mean, the weekend's been great. Some great men's curling. You're going to see a great game going on tonight. And the mixed doubles, it's first time that we sort of threw out a little bit of a championship. Canadians came on board. And it's exciting. Some of the top teams are going to play, our defending champions 2 years ago and last year playing. So we'll see how it all plays out.
And you're technically retired from men's play. How has it felt so far? Big change, little change?
Not much of a change yet. Haven't missed it yet, but I'm sure play down season will be a little bit different.
You're famous for your 360 degrees spiral delivery. Are you doing that at home still?
Yeah, just sweeping the floors, I guess. But no, just you know, I'm lucky to be involved in the game with Curling Canada, and I'm so happy to be able to do that. So I still get to come to clubs, watch some great curling.
Now, is it true that in 2002 you made a cameo with Men in Brooms? Men with Brooms, I should say.
Yes, I did the spinorama in that one, yes.
Any memorable moments from being on set there?
Yeah, it was kind of a few interesting moments there. Meeting Paul Gross, who was the star of the show, Leslie Nielsen. Madaw's team got a big photo of him giving everyone the bird, and so it was a lot of fun.
We talked to Paul Robson about this. Just how special is it that this tournament can stay in Portage La Prairie year in and year out?
It's fantastic. I mean, now that they've combined the men's and ladies basically only one weekend apart, it's great for the community to be able to come out and see these world-class athletes. They're bringing in teams from all over the world. You can't see anything better, and we're hoping that the mixed doubles will continue with that tradition.
Thank you very much for your time, Jeff.
Thank you.
We will go to break. You are watching the 2015 Canadiens Men's Classic on Shaw TV.
Tavern United, a new world sports pub. With a wide selection of sporting events televised at our 8 locations in Manitoba. Tavern United, your destination for great sports all the time.
Welcome back to the 2015 Canadiens Men's Classic. It's Team Laycock leading Team Cooey 2-0, a deuce in the first for the Saskatchewan rink. And if Canadiens wasn't involved in curling enough, now they've added mixed double. What's
good
that all about?
Them. I think that's fabulous. See, the decision in Sochi last year was that by the IOC was that mixed doubles would be another discipline put into the next Olympics. And so for sure, for Canada, it's a hurry up of what will be our process, how will we determine our champions, you know, how will they do it. And so they brought Jeff on as a manager, if you will, of that program. And one of the things that he did was take advantage of these two events. And the reason that's critical is players like Charlie Thomas, who were here for the men's, but who represented Canada with Kaelin Park last year at the Worlds, he came and will stay to play in it. Kaelin can come early for the women's and play in it. So it saves teams having to spend a lot of money on travel when they're both in the same place. And I think that's great.
And Charlie Thomas had a pretty good run.
Oh, he had a great run.
Took out some big names in this event and made it all the way to the semifinals before losing to Team Laycock. And they factored in the playoffs in every World Curling Tour event they've played in thus far. So
first rock in the perfect position, biting the button maybe a little bit deep. So the corner guard was thrown. A rock thrown in front of it, and the Cooey team just trying to manipulate stones, wound up rolling behind the guard. And so this is trying to pick that stone out. If he hit the corner guard, Steve would not be devastated either. Just about removing those stones. And now for Kevin Cooey, he still has that option of utilizing that.
You're up.
Instead asking Brent Lang to hit this outside stone and roll either in front of that shot stone on the lid or right across and underneath to the corner guard.
Whoa, weight's good, clean, yep. Oh. Yep. Hard. Hard, real hard, real hard.
Stay with it, Mark.
Yep.
Yep.
Throw it back to the edge four. Yep.
It's kind of in between. Didn't roll right in front of that center stone or behind, but the good thing that he did is that he did tap that stone back a little bit, inching it behind the tee line, something that they can't potentially freeze to later.
Probably make both with same weight, control up.
When you heard him start that sentence, you can probably make both. His theory is that in coming across and hitting that stone, you probably will make the double as you roll under.
Into second stones now, the first for Brent Lang. Laycock, line two. A little thin.
Now that has one more rotation for Brent in terms of having a little bit further to go, and he's got that shot. You can see the movement. He does curl enough to make contact with that second stone, but not remove it from play, and he does get a bit of a roll, just not right under.
First for Colton Flash.
Yeah, hard.
Yeah, it is blue. Looks like about a half. Thick half. Yeah, thick half, two thirds. Hard to play that if I get back.
Could go here, I guess.
If I'm just back tee, it's not that easy a shot.
Oh yeah, if you have the good curl, yeah, I agree.
I think it's the call. He'll be following us, I think. Well.
The reason Kevin asked Mark how much he could see is he was not interested in playing the hit. He wants to make sure that if they come just to full 8 foot, how much could the Laycock team see, and would they be able to slash it sideways and remove a buried stone? And with hearing that three quarters, you can. And so the decision is to play around the corner, but to go behind the tee line so that you can't use, as in Steve Laycock, that blue stone to get rid of it.
Where are you? Right beside it. And curl that.
This might be easier, Steve. We keep that one. We can keep that if I make it this way.
Well, if you're here, they don't have it anymore anyway, though.
Okay.
Probably easier, hey?
No, I think they're the same, considering what mine last one there. But it's okay. I like this. You guys like this? Yeah.
There's that slash that I just talked about.
You want to throw it hard?
All right, yeah, maybe not. Up to
you. The Cooey team was hoping that Mark Stone would stop about a foot and a half up almost beside it. That takes away that play off the blue one, but stopping where it did.
Steve, half a rock. Quarter's fine.
Yeah.
Hear what they need, a quarter to a half, and we heard Mark Kennedy say he can see three quarters. So all plus accessible to him for what he needs.
Yeah.
Hard, boys. Hard. Hard. Really gotta go. Hard. Hard. Harder.
Great brushing to get that stone by the guard. Kevin Cooey had rushed up thinking that potentially it might rub. So the same shot for Mark Kennedy.
Is it kind of edge-edge, or?
We got a little more than edge.
Oh, we got a little bit?
We got a little bit.
Oh, yeah.
I think just that half weight, Steve.
Think so.
I thought I just touched mine over a bit, but that sure went.
When did you play this?
Board, basically here.
Oh, yeah, yeah, it moves.
Yeah. Is this what you need?
Yeah, that's good.
Hack weight.
It's only the second end, and Kirk saying, this is what happened with mine, and Steve says, when did you play this? That's funny.
And they've played the fewest games of any rink.
Yeah.
But still.
Yeah,
you know,
it's your sixth game, and I'm trying to recall all the shots, and the games start to blur a little bit, especially on a three-game day.
Into skip stones now, the first for Steve Laycock.
Whoa, clean.
Big hack.
Whoa.
Clean.
Clean.
Whoa.
Yep.
Whoa.
Yep.
Yep.
Whoa.
Whoa, whoa,
whoa.
Whoa,
whoa,
whoa.
Whoa,
whoa,
whoa.
Whoa,
whoa, whoa.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Whoa,
whoa,
whoa.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Whoa, whoa.
Freeze it is for him?
Well, can he freeze tighter?
Are you going to be above it though? So if you're a little bit above it and you freeze, and
Look where he is. I'll be just late.
And you might be able to nose it.
I wonder if this is better.
Yeah.
That would be better.
Yeah.
Okay, make the call. I mean, if you just chisel off it a hair, okay. Right?
Mm-hmm.
I move it like that.
The weight's the same, isn't it?
It's close to the same.
Yeah.
It's just, yeah, like something like that.
It's
no
terrible.
Good.
You gotta move it in.
I just don't see him missing that one. But mind you, he's gotta make it too, right?
He might just nose it too.
Yeah, I think that's what he does. If I do that.
Got more room for error.
It's
to
not
make
as
that.
Easy for him, right?
Yeah. Okay. So you're throwing back eight. Almost easier with the intern.
Yeah,
what do you
that's
think?
What, it's just then if I'm. It takes away kind of the freeze on the seven, though, if it.
Kind of. Yeah, kind of. It's.
I like the out.
Okay.
We saw Ben's a bit. It. He was through, but.
Didn't do much, hey? Track's pretty good.
Shade less.
The concern by freezing into that pocket is that if Steve Laycock comes down right on top of it, whether he freezes or hits it on the nose, it's going to be really difficult for Kevin Cooey and his team to score more than one, and they're still trying to find a way to score two. So the decision is to play the freeze, but to tap the stone on the right as you look at it, in the 8 foot back a little bit, so that there might be room, not only for Steve Laycock to jam, they feel, but maybe for Kevin to find a way to score the two.
Cooey has the hammer here in the second end after giving up a deuce in the first.
Well, you saw those numbers. That really has a lot to do with that second stone of his that did not curl over and allowed the hit by Steve Laycock for the pair.
Four blue Laycock stones in the house. And how close was that, Kathy, to what they anticipated?
Well, it's pretty close. They wanted to just have that tap weight. The question was whether they felt Steve Laycock was going to play the hit or the draw. Kevin Cooey felt that he would play the hit, and that is the call that he's playing. What will be key is when he hits the stone, where does he hit it, and does it provide a little bit of a jam and a scattering of stones, and is there a chance for two?
Cock lead on the nose.
Believe I just heard him say hack weight only, so not trying to have a lot of movement with those blue stones behind. Really key that to stay right on top of the yellow stone. He's been perfect so far.
Whoa! Whoa!
Well, it's a circling, trying to figure out who is shot. Really hard to tell.
Come have a quick look, Benny.
Cooey's yellow, Laycock blue.
No. I'm not telling you.
Well, yeah, or the draw.
I'd rather just draw it.
Now you're bringing line into play.
Yeah, I just don't. I can't really tell. That's half or off of the groove.
It is really tough, and sometimes in hanging our cameras straight over, they're not perfectly square, and so we can't tell, and clearly they can't tell.
We're not even half, though, are we, Mark?
Yeah.
I think it's us too. But. Let's take the same track and I'll draw, and then once the line's good, if you move it a hair.
Okay, I had you here.
And I need to take a shade off, right? For weight?
Yeah, but you barely got to the one.
There is just probably not even an inch, maybe a half an inch between those blue stones, and that would be all Kevin Cooey would need to do is to touch it that far to ensure the second point, but you don't want to play any weight against that area if you are already shot. So you heard the call, he's going to play the draw, and if the line's good, they'll play the little bit of a tap.
Do they risk moving that yellow stone?
What I'm worried about, Flat.
That's why he's just going to play the draw and let the sweepers take it that extra little bit if the line is good.
Drop last rock.
Sorry, Mike.
Second end. Cooey down two. Looking for a deuce of his own here.
Hey, we're lined on ours right now.
Oh.
Well
then.
Stay with it.
Yep. Go ahead.
Hart.
Come on, Benny.
Hart, Benny.
Come on, Mike. Get a touchdown.
Hart.
Go.
Looks like two yellow.
Two it is.
And mission accomplished. They did move that blue stone back.
They did indeed.
Just a hair, and that's how good these two rinks are. And so we're tied at two after two ends of play. Lots more curling to come from the Canad Inns Men's Classic. Stay tuned.
ShawTV, we are proud to bring you live events and we value your comments. Call the ShawTV viewer response line now, 204-480-3500, or email us, ShawTVWinnipeg@shaw.ca, and let us know how we're doing. Or find us on Facebook and Twitter at ShawTV Winnipeg.
Tavern United, a new world sports pub. With a wide selection of sporting events televised at our eight locations in Manitoba. Tavern United, your destination for great sports all the time.
And there's a look at the hardware here at the Canad Inns Men's Classic. We started with 32 teams. We're down to two rinks standing. And one of these two rinks out here, either Kevin Cooey's or Stephen Laycock's, will lay claim to those trophies, and the $18,000 first place check, $10,000 to the finalists, and it's been a great week here. Seven countries represented, Olympic champions, world champions, Briar champions, and it's a triple knockout, so we clearly have probably the top two teams, Kathy, here this week in the final.
For sure. You know, you do. It's not a modified, and so it really is one of those events where you have to lose those three times to be going home. Yeah. It's interesting. Both times that Kevin Cooey's team has thrown that center guard, Steve Laycock has not made any attempt to go around it. In the first hand, he went out to the wings, this time trying to play the split, trying to move that stone off the center line and roll in. Shot we refer to the Lisa Weagle more than anything else.
Good response from the skip Cooey after what happened in the first end. Nice delicate play there
Very
in the second
nice.
To get his deuce.
Very patient he was in manipulating stones and not throwing a lot of weight, trying to play some draws.
We talked about the mixed doubles. We've got the women's here beginning Thursday.
We do. It's fantastic. Another very strong field as they've drawn for the men. In the programs that they give out, they have both the men's draw and the women's draw, which I think is terrific because you have an opportunity to see who all will be here. And again, it is a combination of national and international teams. Cissy Osland has been here for some time since Sweden, and she is playing today, I believe, in the finals of Kamloops. So their journeys across Canada have taken them all over the place to play.
Any other good storylines you see there?
Well, Siegfriedson, of course, Olympian. Mm-hmm. Jennifer Jones, very well known. And, of course, a lot of the top Manitoba teams will be here.
And that begins Thursday at 1:30 in the afternoon.
No.
He opens up the front. Still does leave the corner guard that he can utilize later.
Not too high. I think on this one you want to be out here.
Line two, Kevin Cooey looking to try to steal in this end.
Shot TV will be here for the Women's Classic, by the way. We'll do two games on Saturday, and we'll have the championship final for you next Sunday as we look at Brent Lang.
Maureen Bonner will be working alongside you. You had better bring your very tall shoes.
Yes, I'll have to pull those out of the closet.
Circa disco.
They're the Elton John ones.
Yes, I would hope so.
Maureen's tall, and I'm not.
That's a great guard.
Tate, in turn.
I think Steve's initial thought was to run that corner guard onto that stone that's behind the blue, and it would do two things. Maybe get rid of it, but for sure roll that center guard off. Colton's preference was to run it straight back, pick the stone out of the forefoot, and that is now the call.
Good boards. I'm thinking the end, like in one, we played, came up a bit, but not crazy.
Other options lying one, you could decide to go around the center guard.
Yeah, I like that. Good board. Clean. Whoa. Clean. Yep. Hard.
Wow, that just took off.
Oh, it has to fit. Around the center? Top eight?
shot.
Here's another look, Kathy.
Well, we're right behind, and it didn't appear that Brennan really turned that in by any means, but it jumped, and it gets a really bad outcome. You know, I'm sure he'd be happier to have missed altogether, because what he winds up doing is chipping his own far enough that, in fact, it is now that blue stone at the top that has become shot. And so momentum shift for sure. Steve Laycock has the opportunity to draw to lie two.
I think we better go back to the original. That's true. Yep. Maybe a pound more, but you should be good.
Last of the second stones.
You might get a touch if you can.
Colton Flash, perfect after two ends. Laycock with the hammer here in the third. An exchange of deuces so far in this game.
Oh, hell. You told me it was half. You had a touch more of it.
In fairness to the front end, they gave a, or the two sweepers, because you've got the lead in the third, they gave a call early that Colton was really heavy through, and you heard them say, get a tick if you can. And they did get the rub, but Steve said he didn't realize it was that heavy, or they would have got a bigger chunk. That's the plan B, and it's the option that you have to think of early, call early, and share as much information as you can to try to get the most out of every shot.
Just nice, normal, not too big.
Okay.
Give you a bit more ice, I guess.
Okay.
Yep.
Into third stones now, Mark Kennedy.
Hard. Hard. Hard liner. Go, 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 hard.
Oh.
I just saw your ice, do I think.
That's good, man.
Well, he took more ice on Mark's than he did on Ben's, and they worked pretty hard to make sure that didn't jam straight back. Still made contact with that second stone.
I think we're all behind the center. The rest will take care of
itself. Yeah, control is fun.
Let's go, boys. Stay close. We'll get some leaf in.
Roll.
Did he off?
Oh, I got almost exactly half.
Okay.
Well, they know from watching Brent Lang and Mark Kennedy Stone what the break is going to be, and you're going to get that big movement at the end. It does go back onto that other yellow stone, but they're not particularly worried about that with last rock. And the big thing here is the roll. Great brushing to try to take it as far over as they can.
How hard this looks.
It's,
I'd be worried if you made, the only thing I'm worried about is if you make this good, he just kind of comes and bumps here and maybe.
Yeah. Okay, I don't mind hack then.
Does it look pretty tough?
Yeah.
I think you got it.
Yeah, I think they're both tough. I'll throw you a hack.
Should go straighter in here.
Yeah, I know. Until it starts to curl. Wow. You know what, boys? Let's make it. Good throw there with hack. It's cool.
Well, good numbers for Mark, but most importantly, one of the things he brings to this team is just his positive attitude.
Yep.
Whoa!
Easy, guys.
Whoa!
Easy.
Whoa.
Easy.
Both!
Make sure that's open!
Yep. Both of them.
Keep going,
guys. Just
go,
make
go,
it
go,
up!
Go, 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 go.
Yeah,
no broom. Same
way?
Sure.
No, I don't think you can make a roll.
Normal?
No. All I do is hit, like, it basically knows if it's normal. You know what I mean?
Let's roll.
Same way, guys.
Yep. Let's go.
Last of the third stones, another hit and roll, Kathy.
It is for sure, and they certainly have thrown a lot of rocks in this path.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that was breaking in that very similar spot before it rolls open. For Kevin Cooey from the hack, we'll be able to see all of that stone.
Yeah, you did. It came up pretty good. Yeah. If anything, though, it's straightening up a bit. I'm just half.
First stone for Kevin Cooey, who lost in the final last year to Mike McEwen, and won back in 2012, winning an All-Alberta final against Kevin Martin. They can't quite keep the line, and it was tight.
We talked about how sometimes when you get down to single sheets that there are some differences from what you have played on all week, and I think that both skips have been caught a little bit by that outside in shot, the intern going away on the right-hand side, and that out turn just breaking a little bit faster with those quieter weights than they anticipated.
I think a minimum, but that usually is how I think, right? So I think that's good. You want to hit about a half on that four, right? And bump it back to about here, ideally. Don't need to be cute, but.
And what does that last shot, Kathy, do to
right
the complexion
here,
of this end?
Well, with the hammer for Steve Laycock, a great opportunity to lie two, and if he's able to separate the stones, very tough for Kevin Cooey to get out of this without giving up that two that he worked so hard to get back in the second end.
Let's take a hair more.
Yeah, I agree.
First stone for Steve Laycock. He has the hammer here in the third, a 2-2 tie in the championship final.
He's trying to tap that stone. Want to make sure that Kevin Cooey can't hit and roll behind from it. Wow, that jumped. I can see that's a spot that Kevin Cooey got caught. We're just outside of the hog line. It seems to take a left-hand turn. But his weight was good. He separated the stones. If that guard is not there, there is a double for sure. But that guard takes away that opportunity.
Yeah, I'm gonna roll open. That's
middle of the rock.
So Kevin trying to hit and roll under.
Shade more.
I gotta throw this hard or else it jams. So try and just roll.
Peek an inch out on your side. Peel.
And what he's talking about, why he's gonna throw it that hard, is to get the roll. It's going to hit on the inside of where Mark's broom is. That will drive it back to that yellow stone on the right-hand side. Wants to make sure he's got enough weight that it spins out and doesn't leave the opportunity for three.
Whoa.
And you heard Kevin under his breath say nice throw, not very happy with how that came out of his hand. And so a draw now, the full 12 will give Steve Laycock and his team that 2-point advantage once again.
Five. Your line, Dallin.
Last rock, third end, Steve Laycock with a chance to add another deuce and regain the lead.
And no doubts whatsoever. There's your deuce.
No problem. So it's been all deuces here thus far. 4 points for Steve Laycock, 2 points for Kevin Cooey. 4-2 is your score through three ends. Back with much more of the Canadiens Men's Classic in a moment.
Levitt Machinery WHL Hockey is live on Shaw. Watch Wednesday, October 28th, when the Lethbridge Hurricanes storm into the Coliseum for a big battle with the Vancouver Giants. Levitt Machinery WHL Hockey, only on Shaw.
I'm Amy Purdy. At 19, I contracted bacterial meningitis. With less than a 2% chance to live, I slipped into a coma and lost both of my legs below the knee. Now I have lots of legs, and I feel lucky. Lucky to be alive, so I can tell you, not all meningitis is the same. Not all vaccines are the same. Get the one that fully protects your child. The Meningitis Research Foundation of Canada can help. Now you know.
Canadiens Destination Centers. Proud to support our community with 10 destination centers in Manitoba.
Welcome back to Portage. We're up in the Tavern United. Mike Beauregard, Kathy Gauthier, Mike Valente. The championship final of the Canadiens Men's Classic. 4-2 is your score. Steve Laycock of Saskatchewan leading Kevin Cooey, former world champion. Lots of curling to come.
Well, you could hear Kevin's frustration. He left the ice after the last end, just to sort of take a breather and resettle. I'm sure that when we see his numbers this end, they're not going to be particularly good. He was 63 coming into this end, and then he rubbed the guard in the process of getting in there and removing the Laycock stone. And then on his next one, he was trying to throw upweight hit, just did not let go good.
Weight's good.
We heard that out of his hand, and as a result, it was a relatively easy draw.
Weight's really nice.
For Steve Laycock, and he made no mistake at capitalizing on that miss.
Laycock's team, Kathy, hasn't lost. They've played six games. They're 6-0. Conversely, Cooey's team's had to play nine games, so three more games in a fairly short period of time.
And you got to remember, too, that these teams also fly in, so there's a day there. And, you know, they go from one event to another, and they're long events, and they do start to wear away at you, and that's another reason that being physically fit is so important, because one of the first things that we know that when you get tired, the oxygen stops flowing to your brain as quickly and your thinking process goes, and that's when you get a little bit sloppy. And I'm not suggesting at all that that's the case with Kevin Cooey's team. These guys play all the time, but sometimes you're just that little bit off, and Steve Laycock's making them pay.
And you've got to lose your focus just a bit.
Oh, takes so little.
Wait, close, Kev. Right. Line's good. And for T-line.
Line's good. Line's good.
Room.
Line's perfect. Stay with it.
Line's good.
Here's a great example for young folks that are watching about how to utilize stones to your advantage. You threw the corner guard, there's stones in play, there's no need to play against any of those blue stones right now. You're still on lead stones, so buried around not only his guard, but the stone that Steve Laycock has in the house. And now that's a problem rock for Steve Laycock because of his own stone that's in front of it.
If you're just joining us and wondering, hey, where's Mike McEwen?
Enough to do that?
We can't tell you.
He was gunning for three consecutive championships. In fact, he's won four of the last five here in Portage, but he was bounced early. He was out yesterday afternoon. Was that surprising to you?
For sure it is. I think that, you know, there's no question that last year Mike was the best team in the world. He did not get to the Brier, but that did not take away at all from the fact that they had had a spectacular year. You don't expect to win all of them, but I know that, you know, one of our goals as a highly competitive team was always to ensure that you qualified. You wanted to feel that you were playing at such a level that you would make it to the final eight. What happened once you got through there, you know, you need a little bit of breaks and you need to play really well, but to see him not even, you know, in a qualifying game or a game back from qualifying, I think is a bit of a surprise for sure. He ticks that stone over, but it still is second shot for Kevin Cooey.
Now, the McEwen rink has won twice already this season on the World Curling Tour.
You guys like this at all?
Pretty good.
Great. You like it?
I like it.
Yeah, I like that. If you go here, he's just going.
I think the tendency for some may be, why don't you hit that stone now in the 4 foot to lie two? But it's so early in the end, you're only on your second stone. We've seen rocks jump, and if you hit and roll out, all of a sudden you've given the advantage back to your opponent. By playing in front, you're ensuring that there are rocks in play and a couple of them will be yours. Lots of end to go.
And stick around following this end to Mike Valente. We'll interview both skips at the fourth end break. We're scheduled for eight here on the World Curling Tour.
Hart, where are you? Tuppy.
I don't know.
Coming off of it because they're losing line.
Let's go, buddy. We need you.
No, it's more like in between three quarters and two thirds.
Yeah.
Kind of like control.
I like peel.
I really don't like peel.
Why is that?
If you miss this a little bit, that's great.
Yeah, but we don't ever want to, like, if we ever get it into the back one, like.
You'd have to cross it to do that.
No, not that one, but even just nutting into the back one, we want to make sure we get it out.
Well, if you put peel, it's no better, right?
Wow, you got a margin of error with peel, right? That's my only thought. No, you just have one.
Okay.
And
there was no disagreement on the shot selection. Steve Laycock doesn't see any need to throw a bullet at this, and that's what Colton wants to throw. It's easier to predict what it will do in some ways when you throw up weight. And it may have to do with release for Steve Laycock.
Some big weight from Colton Flash.
And we'll just get that one.
I don't mind the same shot.
Okay, I don't either.
I'll give you more ice. Could be that rock too a bit.
I've wondered about that actually. That's the same rock with Brent twice that jumped more, curled more. And again, you do get to select the stones, so they would have chosen what they want to play with. Sometimes it can be one of those games where you got some movement, there was more teams out there, and you felt that it was more consistent, and you start to see those little bit of inaccuracies showing up when there's only one sheet in play. So those numbers for Brent. Ron Goche here is our statistician this evening. It's always nice to see numbers. Sometimes you feel like you're seeing things, but the numbers will bear that out. Oh, that's great brushing.
Is that better than hitting it out?
And we've paid Ron in Canadian's French fries.
And beverages.
Look at that work.
They are two of the best, those two.
I got this much.
Okay.
I think that's a shot, eh? Just as easy as a draw.
Hawk?
Yeah.
So for Steve Laycock, playing the board a little bit, board meaning the scoreboard, up two, feeling that if they can eliminate that stone at the back, they would not be playing this if that yellow stone were third or fourth shot, or rather fourth or fifth shot, but because it is in fact a potential counter, want to make sure that that goes away.
Here we go. Hard, you keep coming.
So for Team Laycock, they've eliminated that, but for Kevin Cooey, it has not changed his circumstance at all. Still gives him lots
probably
to work with.
A little back for.
Good.
Yeah, try and get it behind the board.
He's going down there, and those ones going down there. Is it going to be close to full speed now?
Even.
So okay, so Benny threw. I guess Benny threw 5 feet more, and it was back eight.
Even back eight. So back close, four, though. Back eight.
I just won't. I won't be. That's
can
what
you
I'm thinking.
Freeze
too.
Here, pretty tough, eh?
Really tough.
That's positive T line. Let us know though if I'm a little heavy, we can make that freeze.
The only reason they feel that freeze is pretty tough, you heard Kevin say that, is there may not be enough ice to hold it out there long enough to freeze on that back one. So the objective is to draw behind. But you heard him say, if I'm heavy, that's an option.
Yep, go ahead, man. That's four. Hard line, Katie. Hard, Katie. Got to go on this blue. Hard. Keep going. Hard. Real hard. Go, 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 go.
Keep going.
Wow. That's three shots in a row. Two for Cooey, one for Laycock. Just brilliant sweeping.
So?
Yeah, just free that one up and
absolutely
get that out.
Hit a what?
About a quarter.
Yeah. Third's probably okay.
Yeah, you'll spin up a bit.
But that's max, so. Out turn, probably straight up.
Sure.
So they know there's no way to remove that yellow stone on the left-hand side as you're looking at it right now, but they can use it as a way to get to that stone just thrown by Mark Kennedy. So it's about eliminating one of the stones. They're going to free up that blue one that is currently shot and frozen so that they'll have access to it later.
Second stone for Kurt Myers. Here's another look. Kathy spills the one yellow and that other one just doesn't move. But it's freed up.
It is.
4 inches.
Just draw, freeze on here and move it.
Just got to move it a little.
I mean, I don't know if he guards. But.
Straight fleas blue, if I'm ever this far across the nose, it's a double. If we, as long as we move ours and stay high side, there's no double. Yeah, at the most. Even if you bump it, yeah, 16. Bump it and roll to half frozen. Or bump it and roll it dead frozen. I'm pulling.
I don't think this will curl quite as much.
Okay, I'm pulling back four.
Last of the third stones, Mark Kennedy's second.
Well, tight. That's good. That's good.
Right on. Cooey down 4-2 here in the fourth.
It's not doing anything. Now they're trying to change the shot at the end to take away the double. That did nothing compared to what we've seen come out of Brent Lang's hand.
Just the hero side.
Confusion for sure for Kevin Cooey holding the broom.
Yep.
About what it, in fact, will do.
I think so. Yep. Yeah, it might just get away with nose.
Yeah.
Well, draw it isn't. We'll peel it, should just go down there, yep.
Into skip stones now, Steve Laycock, looking to spill some yellow rocks.
There you go.
Rid of both.
Well, a great job by Steve Laycock of taking advantage of opportunities as they presented themselves. Stone from Marks just not curling enough, allowed the double, and it's made.
Or this looks real hard. Well, I either got him. Of this?
We'll be a rock higher, though. It'll.
I think you can hit a quarter pretty safe. Do you like this at all?
If he guards, though, that's not. There. You only have to move it a foot and a half. Yeah, it's okay.
Definitely there.
Yeah.
Two thirds. If you move it an inch, it's there right now.
So they're lining them up. You play the freeze on that stone that shot or tap it back an inch or two. Pretty tough for Steve Laycock to pick it out. And if he does throw the guard, you will have the double off the stone that's to the right of the broom across to the other one. Kevin Cooey still looking for the potential to score two.
Kevin Cooey with the hammer here in the fourth. Gave up a deuce in the first and another in the third.
Hard break. Hard break. Never off.
Go.
Never off. Gotta go, guys.
Come on,
get
Rick.
Second.
Gotta get there.
Go.
Gotta get there. Line's good.
Keep going.
Sorry, guys.
How makeable do you think that is? How makeable is that?
If we throw a guard, we might steal one. Or it's a four-end game with hammer. I said, if we throw a guard, it's a four-end game with hammer at worst, or we're up by three.
Force is pretty good too, though, right?
I know. I guess I'm getting greedy.
I think he probably scores one if he misses it too. So.
Yeah, you're right. This one's pretty thin though, Steve. Let's pick it out.
There almost isn't a jam.
Yeah, I think hit a quarter and be good, hey?
Well, they considered for a moment throwing a guard on that stone and trying to find a way to steal. You heard Kirk say there's a chance to go up three, but it is Kevin Cooey that's throwing. They know that he's really good at up weight, and they looked at that double. It's certainly there. It's tough, but it's there. They don't want to have a tie game if they don't need to, and so you pick this out. The most that Kevin can do is get one, and then you're one up with as you start the second half.
Last stone for Laycock, who has the better numbers. Gets rid of the yellow stone.
Was that curling much, that one, or just?
The one you just threw?
Mine.
You were just a sliver tight, but you threw it good.
Thinking there?
That's for backline, yeah.
Guess you still have to be concerned a bit, Kathy, with that stretch of ice, huh?
You do, and there's, you know, that big movement is as it comes off, I'm going to say the 4-foot lines, even though there aren't any here, but it would be a line extending from the edge of the 4-foot. That's the big motion, and that blue stone on the right-hand side that we look at that's sort of half covered by the guard, if it starts to over-curl, that comes into play, but Kevin also wants to make sure that it's not going to hang out because it is a very precise shot. Chance to draw within one.
Last rock, fourth in. Kevin Cooey drawing against five. And he gets his one to cut the lead to 4-3. The hammer goes back to Team Laycock for the fifth. So we're through four ends of play, and there's your score, Kathy. 4-3, Team Laycock undefeated in this event, leading by one as we head to the second half of our match. Maybe a thought or two on just what you've seen thus far.
Well, I think that, you know, we talked at the beginning of the show about how if you look on paper, the advantage would be the Cooey team with all of the accomplishments that they have made. And Steve for sure has a bunch of his own, but there's not a gold medal pair on his team and not a world championship at this point for men's. And so, you know, you look at that advantage, but I did say, you know, when we talked, Steve Laycock, the only undefeated team, they're very comfortable out here and they're looking very comfortable tonight.
And his team leads by one through four with the hammer for the fifth. And Steve Laycock is standing by now with Mike Valente. Mike.
Thanks very much, Steve. How does it feel? It all comes down to this, through four ends, 1-point lead.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Good first half. There's a few deuces exchanged there, and we just got our force here, so that's nice heading into the second half, up one with hammer.
What have you liked about your team's effort throughout the course of the weekend?
We've made it a lot of hit and rolls. That's really helped set up some ends, and we've peeled really well. So those are a good combination, and draw weight's been pretty good too. So, I mean, really, we're firing all cylinders right now for the most part.
Absolutely. Thank you very much for your time. We'll move on to Kevin Cooey here. Kevin, take us through that final end that we just saw. What was the strategy there?
You know, we were sitting good, just trying to get a deuce. We've struggled a bit getting the broom in the right spot and just a couple small misses.
How do you bounce back in the final four ends?
Yeah, we just, you know, it's no secrets. We just got to play well. Probably need a bit of maybe a miss or two from them. But, you know, we're only down one, so we're still in it.
Good luck. Appreciate your time. And we will go to break. This is the 2015 Canad Inns Men's Classic from Portage La Prairie here at Canad Inns on Shaw TV.
sometimes we all need our space. And that goes for recyclables too. Toss them loosely into the bin without stuffing containers into one another. For more recycling tips from Multi-Material Stewardship Manitoba, visit simplyrecycle.ca.
Tavern United, a new world sports pub. With a wide selection of sporting events televised at our 8 locations in Manitoba. Tavern United, your destination for great sports all the time.
Steve Laycock's team trying to run the table here at the Canadiens Men's Classic, trying to go undefeated here in the championship final, leading 4-3 over Kevin Cooey through four ends of play. And Kathy, I think Kevin Cooey summed it up best there in his interview. Hasn't curled the best, admittedly, but they're only down by one with four more ends to go.
Well, and it's interesting. You know, he said that they struggled about putting the broom in the right spot, and the biggest difference has been on Brent Lang's shots, especially that one rock of his. And, you know, I do wonder whether they've had that discussion, whether it's, you know, that the ice that's fooling them, or Kevin's getting a read or a misread off Brent's and then trying to follow that through, because that does seem to have been the tricky spot. But, you know, you don't feel like as a team that you're playing all that well. You're down one with four ends to go. That's not too intimidating for a team like the Cooey team. It's probably been in a lot worse situation to come back to win games.
A $60,000 purse here in Portage. $18,000 will go to the winning team. $10,000 to the finalist. It's the biggest purse on the World Curling Tour thus far this year. And quite an event here in Portage, put on by Canad Inns. We're up in the Tavern United. And there's a curling club and a hotel and the tavern all rolled into one in the destination center here in Portage.
It always smells great up here. The food is awesome.
It's tough to do a broadcast without ordering something.
Wait tonight.
Which is why I took care of that before the game, so you didn't have to listen to me and my stomach grumble the entire game.
Now, if you love curling and you've never made it down here, make a point of coming next weekend or starting Thursday.
Or even this week for the mixed doubles.
The mixed doubles, we've got some of the top rinks in the world here in Portage. So a 10-day stretch of tremendous curling, and all made possible because of the commitment by Canad Inns.
And a very strong volunteer base that support this club as well.
And as you mentioned yesterday, Kathy, this event has gone on in different shapes and sizes for many years here in Portage.
It has always been a favorite stop on the tour, not only because of the facility, but because I think it was the 1986 World Juniors that were held in here, and that was the year that Kathy Overton was the Canadian representative. Pea Lindholm, I believe, won, and he fell in love with the Saddlers of Portage and Portage, and for years would come back to Canada and always want to come out to Portage. And I think did as much advertising for this entire area as anyone has ever done. And, you know, people started to hear about how great Portage was. And so if they didn't have, you know, an event that weekend, they'd start to come. And once teams came here, they always came back because of the ice. And it is also, like you say, it's a very big check.
And that was way before we saw this huge influx European teams.
Oh, for sure. Kevin Cooey's got his work cut out for him. Wouldn't be unhappy with a force, but certainly is going to look for a way to steal. Weight by Brent, great judgment by the sweepers.
Yeah, Hacker, feel whichever you're feeling.
Well, as we mentioned off the top, both of these teams have had tremendous success early this year. The Laycock team has made the semifinals in three of the four World Curling Tour events they've participated in. And Cooey's team has won their last two events.
Nice shot by Colton. Says his preference was to throw the big weight shot in four, given the choice there by Steve to play either the hack weight shot against the shot stone or peel the front. He felt confident enough and great outcome. Brent turn around right away. Obviously something peripheral vision. We saw that there was something on the ice. It does not seem to be affecting the stone.
Heart. Every inch. Go, Ben. Go, Ben. Go, 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 go. Keep going. Go, 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 go.
Are we trying to finish this? You have to get by that front guard by quite a bit because you have to deal with that blue stone and the 8 foot. That one tucked a little bit better. So Steve Laycock is not going to risk just ticking things over. We'll remove that center guard.
Yep.
Second stone for Colton Flash.
We're not gonna steal here.
I don't know what's going over there is gonna do. Is it an 8 and a kicker?
Time for a team huddle.
And why are we not gonna steal if we have a center line guard? He's peeling, right?
Yeah, we took two guards.
No matter where I put it, he's peeling.
I don't really like the guard.
Guard, he's...
I mean... You're guarding this?
Yeah. We'll always have a center guard no matter what. That's pretty much a center guard as well.
You think he's gonna freeze?
Well, you hope he freezes, because then you freeze.
Yeah. Well, I don't think he does.
No, he peels.
He maybe eventually bumps this up. I just think if you're, it seems dangerous to do that all in. Like, it's gonna be tough to take both away. Like, you know how much it curls here.
Well, yeah, we're probably gonna have to make moves first. We keep making guards, we keep stealing, eventually we have to make that pass. Right?
If he ever misses it, high or...
Yeah, I know.
Another one.
That's assuming we make the guards perfect.
He's over there, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Right on.
Okay.
Kev,
split center, I guess.
Kev's still thinking. Okay. He's thinking force, right?
Turn you want.
Probably the in.
Okay. And that's the key, is that they're on two different pages. For Kevin Cooey, he's thinking, how do we force the Laycock team to take one? So if you draw and you freeze to that outside one, even if there's a run back or a tap made, maybe you're in a situation where you force. The rest of the team, the other three at this end, are looking at a stone that is quasi-buried in the back of the forefoot, thinking that if they throw a guard, maybe there's still a way to steal one and bring this game to even. Good to have that discussion, I'm not sure Kevin Cooey is sold on this idea particularly, but he's prepared to go along with what Mark prefers, which is the guard.
No, it's not heavy at all.
Into third stones now, fifth end.
And as they thought, Steve Laycock, without any extra moment of thought, goes up to peel this.
And here's Kirk Myers looking to peel that guard.
Mission accomplished. So Kevin will throw the guard again. Well, some great numbers by Mark. We're so used to seeing that. That's sort of his standard of performance. And people wondered when he moved from second up to third if there would be a dramatic difference. Not at all.
Real hard. Hard landing.
Keep going.
Well, that did not at all finish as the first one did.
How far did they get? They kind of just got by this, eh? Yep. So should we pick it out of there or hack? Or what do you think?
It's great if you make it, yep.
Oh, I feel comfortable. I just threw that shot.
You want to throw peel?
I think that's the easiest, eh?
Okay.
Well, that non-finish, if you will, by Mark Kennedy means that that chunk, probably a third, is exposed. Heard they're going to play peel weight, make it go away.
Second stone for Kirk Myers. Going after that shot stone.
Nicely done. And he absolutely saw that all the way. He had no doubt in his mind that what he could see of it, he was going to make. And so for Kevin Cooey, does not want to give up two, already down one, trying to utilize that guard just thrown by Mark and that stone in the 8 foot as guards for him to bury around.
First of skip stones for Kevin Cooey, curling 69%. Still in the game, though.
Oh, very much so. That's a very nice shot. Still exposed. Great weight. Just looking for that little bit of extra finish at the end.
He's got other shots.
No, I don't. I think that's a pretty good call.
Or he hits and just gives us the one.
Yeah.
I think we peel.
I like that. I mean, I agree, because this is not going to get any harder.
No.
So.
Not going to get any worse than it is now. It's tough to replace that. Good. We'll take her one. He's got to make him stick, too.
Playing the straight peel.
Yep, yep. Let it go. Hard, boys. Let it go. Right
first up. Stone for Steve Laycock, Breyer bronze medalist.
Shot. Here's what we're thinking. You could do something like this. But he's got the double. He could go right here. Yeah. That's no good.
I just think Langer, there's a good chance I'm here and he hardly misses. No. How much of this do you have though?
From his hack, I thought you had a thin half, but.
I would agree with that.
So what I was thinking was, as long as you're just out count.
Like right where Kev's broom is, he's drawing. Well, whatever we do right now is going to have to be pretty good.
Anything's risky.
Whatever the shot is, got to be placed properly. So which one do we have a best chance of making?
It's pretty good. Yeah.
Well, at least you're on the right line where if we have to change plans, we go back eight.
And do you think he's ever playing this come around chase tap?
If he's second.
Like, say I put it over here.
Yeah, I think he does too.
Not that hard. It's hard for us. You guys make the call if you get her back there. No, that's the, I think right here.
Nibble the top four.
It's got to be enough over. It's got to be enough over that he's not doing that, though, right? Hey. You like that, Langer? Not really. I can tell.
No.
No, I'm playing. I'm playing line. Line that's on bite.
It's bite the four or foot. Bite the four.
Right hey. There.
You just tell me if it's the top four biter or the back four biter. Okay.
This is a very precise shot because to be top four, you bring the steel into play. Back four is not bad. You bring the force into play. You slide a little bit deep and you give him the double for three.
Slip double, since Stevie plays, I think. Maybe.
We put it where we want.
This half a rock is might miss that one. Not if you're biting 4 foot.
Yeah, I think if we're biting 4 foot, I don't think he has one. What do you think of that line, boys? Make it a bit over far enough.
It's a tough one.
Critical shot here, Kathy, without the hammer in the fifth.
It's a weight shot. I don't think
Yeah, I don't think this come around top is a gimme. I don't think it's a gimme. So if you're not sure and you put it back there for third.
Okay. I agree. I definitely don't think that that outturn come around top is a gimme. It seemed to be a little bit straighter in that path. So to have enough weight to tap it back, it might run straight. So the key is not to set up the double, really saying to his team, if you have to take it back for third shot, that's okay, rather than leaving it up higher and allowing the double for three.
You might have to go a little deeper.
I saw his numbers coming in at 69%. That slid just a little bit far. If it stops right there, you take it up about 4 inches.
Hit it about an eighth.
It really eighth takes, eight? This yep. is still a very sharp double.
Ian.
Let's go, buddy.
Ian.
I think if he makes it, it's a loop off. Yeah.
Yep.
Maybe get a, I don't know. That's a good shot. You guys fucking got a good shot.
Degree of difficulty here, Kathy?
Very high. It's very, very thin. Something that Steve obviously likes to play the big weight shot. He feels he's got nothing to lose at a minimum. You get rid of one.
Yep. Whoa.
Whoa. Last rock, whoa. Fifth end, yeah. Laycock whoa. Facing
yeah.
two.
Whoa, whoa, yeah. whoa, yeah. whoa.
Oh, great shot.
And he gets both.
And no jam, that is
three.
A peach. That is a great curling shot. To not only make that shot, but not to jam on the back one. Outstanding.
And here's another look, Kathy.
That is a great, great curling shot. You have to hit that so thin. So essentially it's a knee redirect as I look at Kirk on the ice and it goes across the top of the other stone. Outstanding.
Well, he hasn't missed much in this game thus far. So a hit to score three. And it's a 7-3 lead for Steve Laycock over Kevin Cooey in the final of the Canad Inns Men's Classic. We're back with the sixth end in just a moment. Stay tuned.
Through five ends, it is 7-3 for Steve Laycock's team. Just a quick social media update for you. If you're enjoying our coverage on ShawTV this evening, make sure to log on to Twitter and tweet us at ShawTV Winnipeg. We would appreciate your comments. And for some reason, if you're away from a television, you can also log on to our ShawTV Winnipeg YouTube page and catch a live stream where you can rewind or fast forward. It's totally up to you. An update, next weekend here at the Portage Curling Club, it's the Women's Classic, which starts Thursday the 23rd at 1:30. Our coverage here on ShawTV will be on Saturday at 5 p.m. and 8:30 p.m. And then on Sunday, 6 p.m. will be the final match. That's the Women's Classic right here. It's the Men's Classic, 7-3 the score. It's the 2015 Canad Inns Men's Classic on ShawTV.
Well, a big hit for three there in the fifth end and a 7-3 lead now for Steve Laycock over Kevin Cooey. And if you're the coach for Kevin Cooey, what are you saying? What are you strategizing?
Well, you know what? At this point for Kevin Cooey, it's all, all rocks in, that's for sure. You know what? You need to have everything in play. There might be some taps, there might be some freezes, but you're not going to see any more removal of stones. I'm sure that Kevin Cooey is probably thinking back to the last end, thinking about where he wanted to separate the house and force Steve Laycock to take one. The rest of his team saw an opportunity, and you know what? They could have been right. There could have been an opportunity to steal, but Steve Laycock made it peach. I mean, that is just as good a shot as you are ever going to see.
And that last draw from Cooey was just not quite deep enough, but he didn't seem sure in the house.
Well, you know what? I think that for the sweepers, they were so worried about, you know, positioning. And you heard Kevin say from the hack that he really felt that if the only shot was that outturn tap, it was so difficult that it was okay to actually take it deep. And where they were at the end, there was a little bit of panic, and they swept a little bit too much. If you take that stone up 4 inches, it is so sharp, it's almost not there. And I don't even think that you would have seen Steve play it.
Peel, I think, Steve.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, we just peel and...
So Team Laycock with a 4-point lead.
Really hard.
Hard Duke.
Really
and these
hard
are 8-end games, Kathy.
They are. Teams are required to play six. Kevin will continue to throw a guard on that. Again, you're not going to probably get your four back in a row, but if you can score two this end and draw within two, maybe steal on the next end, and then steal coming home, that is doable. We saw that yesterday in that Hartung Liburn game, that game that, you know, that's a very good team, the Liburn team, and controlled the game, but Hartung just kept pushing and pushing, and next thing you know, it's a great shot to give up two, to go to the extra, and then he didn't have... Sure.
They've played three fewer games, and that has to factor in over a 3 or 4 day period.
They're not too worried, they being the Cooey team, that they are not shot. That stone frozen to the face of it at some point, they can come down and freeze again, or tap it back slightly to get their 2 points. They're trying to make sure, though, that they can score at least two.
Clean it.
Good.
28,000 up for grabs in this championship final. 18,000 to the winning team. And they're playing for the Dave Elias Memorial Trophy, named after former Manitoba champion.
And all around great guy.
So we guard on this one, but then on my next one, we'll see where we put the guard, because if we put it too good, he'll guard. So think about where to put my second one.
And following the game, we'll have interviews and we'll have the trophy presentation, so you want to stick around for that.
And the Cooey team trying to move that guard around a little bit, trying to lure Steve Laycock into playing something against that stone in the house, but he's not at all going to be trapped by that. We'll just continue to peel that guard.
I don't think he's guarding it. I like just the same thing, and then we try here, over here, something on my neck.
Benny's saying maybe if we make a tight guard and it's not in line with the stone, maybe Steve will do something with the stones or guard to steal one that might actually sort of seal the deal, and then they would run their own back in. But I think that Steve's fully aware of the master plan and is not going to play along.
I've often wondered, you know, curling's one of those sports where you actually deliberate the game plan in front of the opponent.
Yes.
And there are no secrets, but are there ever times where you just want to, you know, hold your cards close to the vest?
Yes.
Because you're thinking ahead, two, three shots sometimes.
And lots of teams do the Bill Belichick where they, you know, they don't take their take their board out there and put it in front of their face. But you definitely do see teams that gather up more towards the hog line and are quieter without pointing. So we'll go here and we'll go there. I often say that to the junior teams that I'm involved with. Listen, when the other team is saying, we'll go here, they'll go there, I'll do this, they're telling you their plan. It's so important to know that. Kevin Cooey, very vocal about it. But a lot of teams, you'll see, will talk very quietly and turn their backs to the team and sort of face outwards so that the other team doesn't hear. And that's not a bad idea.
Well, they do it in just about every other sport.
Yes.
They have things like huddles, and they'll talk with their hands in front of their mouths so that
Absolutely.
People can't read lips. And
boys, if we're anywhere high and we don't move it, it's like even that's not the end of the world, but make it good.
Somewhere you lock it right on. And it starts to be two, hoping that Steve Laycock will make a play against it.
Yeah, okay. I don't know. I mean, they're coming off way out
Shot
here.
Shot stone for
well,
sure
I
is the blue stone
here.
Belonging to Steve Laycock.
I'd say that's close. I gave you just a hair outside edge.
Kevin Cooey gave up two in the first, two in the third, and three in the fifth. Trail 7-3, curling the sixth end.
Hey, line's close.
Line's close.
Line's close. Line's close.
Hard line.
No.
Call the line, Mark.
Yep. Hard line.
Wait on.
Hard line. Hard line. Hard line. Hard line. Get to it. Get to it. Hard. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. It's really good.
Just over curled that little bit. If you take that stone and have it a little bit to the left. It's a dead jam going nowhere. Still pretty.
So with a bit of weight, Kathy, where do those two yellow stones end up?
Well, it'll be more than a bit of weight. I'll be throwing it, just putting it out there. I'll be throwing it pretty hard. You will get momentum off that, looks like a four, that middle stone that will go sideways to the left. One of the yellows will stay for sure. But Steve certainly has the ability to throw up weight.
Last stone for Steve Laycock. Cooey has last rock.
There's that yellow one we said would go to the left, does leave one, and so it will be a draw to the paint for Kevin Cooey for two.
Last rock, sixth end. Kevin Cooey with a chance to draw for two and cut into this lead, which makes this task of coming back from a 7-3 deficit less daunting, Kathy.
You bet.
He gets his deuce and cuts the lead to 7-5. A couple of ends to go. And so the score, 7-5. Steve Laycock leads Kevin Cooey in the championship final of the Canad Inns Men's Classic. Back to Portage with much more after this.
Alex Marchand won seven games.
Eight.
I'm sorry, eight games. In that time, he put together a two-game winning streak, got new uniforms, met an Olympic gold medalist, made the front page of Curling Monthly. He explained to his boss what sweeping does, and got his butt kicked by a guy with a fake hip. Yes, Alex the Hack Marchand has had quite a year, and it all started with a click.
Hey guys, what's up?
Frank forgot to bring the ball.
Sorry.
So now we need something we can throw and kick that's not too big and slightly oblong.
What are you guys looking at? The least I can say, I'm naturally talented at football!
If you love the game as much as we do, go deep with the Shaw Road to the Grey Cup with exclusive interviews, game day features, and more.
Canad Inns Destination Centers, proud to support our community with 10 destination centers in Manitoba.
Here's a look at the Dave Elias Memorial Trophy, named after the two-time Manitoba champion. Passed away a couple of summers ago from cancer, much beloved in this province by the curling community, and a fitting tribute by the folks at Canad Inns. Inns to rename that trophy a couple of years ago, Kathy.
Well, and it also makes it more meaningful to the curlers, I think, knowing that they've won an event that has been named after one of their own. It's a wonderful thing to win a Bonspiel and to be awarded a prize, but it's even nicer when it has that special memory attached to it. All of these guys would have played, David, at one of the Briars or on the circuit during the year. Probably the victim of some of his pranks, I'm going to suggest.
Try and get it a little on this side.
The championship final of the Canad Inns Men's Classic. Kevin Cooey is back in this game, trailing 7-5 now with a couple of ends to go. He's lost the hammer.
Well, it really has been a game that has felt like the Steve Laycock team is all over the Kevin Cooey team, but the Kevin Cooey team just stays there. And if it was not for that brilliant shot made by Steve, this game would be a lot closer instead of a two-point edge and hammer for Steve Laycock as we play in seven.
Laycock made a beautiful hit for three in the fifth, which opened up a 7-3 lead, but Cooey has countered with a deuce to make it 7-5.
Oh, great shot by Dallin to move that guard off of the center. Saw Kevin trying to sweep it over, hoping that he could get it to the boards and have it go back and be replaced. But not so.
Here's Ben Hebert.
Oh,
good. That's good. Keep it over here this time. Yeah.
Play it again or go right here.
Not sure.
I think I like here.
Now what do they do then? Freeze? Peel, 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 hit. Hit for one. Here you go, Duke.
Well, I do agree with this going in at this point.
Light.
The only other option that you could play is just to throw it through and eliminate another stone. But in trying to play a tick shot, all you do is leave the potential to have four guards in front of the house. This, you're going in, and you heard Kirk say, peel, 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 and if the circumstances remain the same, you're forced to take one. That gives you a three-point edge coming home, and that's pretty comfortable for this team from Saskatchewan.
Tap it back a foot, a rock.
Tap it back, not enough that it's easy to pick out, but just so that it goes behind the tee line, something that they can freeze to and get shot.
I think you want to get rid of this one.
Yeah, I like that.
Peel.
All right, flop it through this just a few inch curl, maybe. Let's go, bud. Straight at it.
I always hear Kirk give those technical cues to Colton to go straight at it. It's just that reminder about release.
Clean.
Nicely done.
There's a look at Brent's numbers.
I'm pretty solid, and I think that a couple of those numbers may not have been full fours because of the outcome of his shot, but we kind of wondered if it had picked at first, a couple of them, or whether Kevin had under-iced. He said after that he had, because he gave Mark Kennedy more, and they learnt through Brent Stones that, you know, the ice is just that little bit different tonight with being a single sheet.
Keep going, Mark. Keep going.
And how do you arrive at those percentages, Kathy?
Well,
especially
you know,
when there's some in-between shots, you know.
You know, and it really is subjective. There are some things that are very obvious. If you're playing a wide open hit and you hit and stick, it's a 4 out of 4. If you hit and roll out, it's a 2 out of 4 because you've achieved 50% of the objectives. And obviously, if you miss, you're getting a 0. It's when you're playing around stones and you're tapping stones back that there's subjectivity to it, and that's why, you know, at national championships or events that is high-level curling, the scorers are usually former curlers of a very high nature so that they understand not only what the shot is, but if it's not made 100%, does that give the team, is it really not so bad that it can be utilized? Or if it's deep, it may look not so bad, but, you know, if you're down and you're deep, you know, if you could give a -4 half the time, I'd be doing that. So it really, there is subjectivity for sure, and it really is important that the person scoring really does understand the game.
There's also, I guess, a degree of difficulty to certain shots.
You know what?
At that level.
They've really talked for a lot of years about trying to factor that in because, you know, for a skip making a shot like Steve Laycock did, if he didn't make that shot, you know, it tends to be a 4, a 0, a 2, and yet sometimes you're given a 4 for making an incredible shot, as you would be given a four for making a wide open hit. So they've talked for a lot of time about adding that degree of difficulty factor in, but that also elevates the knowledge level required by a scorer to be able to do that.
Well, you really wouldn't want to do this.
Yeah, no, I understand that, but yeah, well, the intern would be the way to make it.
Yeah.
Oh, there is.
Yeah, there's like.
Oh. I don't call that separation. do you think I can get it out? Like, what do I gotta hit?
To get it out, you probably need to get the 2/3.
Yeah, I think I can.
You saw that,
the guard, not the end of the
that
world,
motion. It's hard for the person from the hack to know. It's one of the clubs in Ottawa.
Yep.
The name escapes me. My daughter played in it last year. They have large mirrors on the end, the far end, that tilt down. So the player in the hack can look at the large mirror and see what the house situation is, and can the fans. And I've always thought it's such a great idea. I'm sure it costs a fortune.
Is that the Hunt Club?
It might. No, not the Hunt Club. I want to say it's not the Ottawa. Maybe the Granite. I think it might be the Granite. But it's just such a great idea because you can see very clearly.
Yeah, the same way you played 2 minutes ago.
And that would be viewed as a good miss. If you're not going to make the shot, at least you've opened it up for yourself.
Well, if you make them try to make that draw, we can go Kevin's guard tight to the house. Let's make this first so we can't hit it.
Great numbers for Mark.
Second stone from him.
No, root. Gotta get an inch past the center. Let's find a good roll. Hard. Keep going.
Covers that stone.
I think so. In turn. Yep.
Trying to make a whole bunch of granite go away. Run this back. Try to clip about a third of those back stones.
That's a lot of cheering for that shot. Well, we have a baseball game
going on up here as well.
And
lots of fans, and what an epic place to watch curling. You can watch curling outside, and while the players are discussing, you can watch the Blue Jays on TV.
It's more important to have the line, because if you can see a piece on either side, he's blasting, right?
Well, he will for sure. If you give him a chance to get to that stone, he will definitely take it.
Into skip stones now, seventh end, the first for Kevin Cooey.
And I would say by those numbers that, you know, it is indicative of him really bringing his game up. Missed a couple early. We heard him muttering about not a very good throw in three when he gave up the deuce. A couple of line issues.
Keep going, go.
Better than Peel, I think.
Picking it?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That's a shot. So then we're only shooting against one, and he's going to bury into here.
Yeah, roll the draw.
Instead of against two, right?
Yep.
So.
Have we seen one here yet?
Just get the home end.
Just get a little bit out of there?
Yep.
I agree. Let's go, bud.
For sure. You have this opportunity to make a play at that stone at the back. If you peel the guard, you can feel pretty confident that the next guard thrown by Kevin Cooey will be much better than that. So this is your chance.
Yeah, and we can't afford, like, we hit the guards. Yeah.
First stone for Laycock in the seventh. Whoa. He has the hammer.
Close. Whoa.
Going after that shot stone.
Wow.
Well, it's better. Really good.
That's a pretty surgical removal of that stone. There is not a lot of space between that yellow and that blue did not move at all.
Straight draw. Like a shade more?
Line's good.
Last stone for Kevin Cooey, seventh end, down by two.
Line's perfect. Top button. Line's good, guys. Right here.
Looks heavy.
Looks heavy.
Sir? Doesn't he?
Sir? Good, Kevin. Good shot.
Good. Settles in for shot.
You know, just that little bit heavy, it did not have the opportunity to catch that curl as it would have with sweeping, and so it certainly is a spot that Steve Laycock can get to, get to the inside, tap it back that little bit for two. At a minimum, coming down with the shot, he will get one if he's down to the face of it.
Last rock, seventh end.
Tee line.
Don't go there.
Steve Laycock with an opportunity to score two.
Tee line only, guys.
Room.
Delicate shot, though.
Room.
Tee line. Tee line. Line's good. Tee line.
Room.
Just tee. Okay.
Whoa. Yep.
Whoa. Let her curl.
Good job, guys.
And there's your one.
And he'll get just the one.
And a three-point advantage coming home.
You bet. Up 8-5 through seven ends of play. So that's where we stand here in Portage. The Canad Inns Men's Classic. Kevin Cooey down by three. Back with more from Portage in just a moment.
And labels, leave them be. When the container is empty, it's ready to be recycled. For more recycling tips from Multi-Material Stewardship Manitoba, visit simplyrecycle.ca.
ShawTV presents the Canad Inns Women's Classic live from Portage La Prairie, Manitoba. The women take to the ice for week two of our Canad Inns coverage, beginning Saturday at 5 p.m. with their final match on Sunday at 6 p.m. Catch the action at the Canad Inns Women's Classic, live from Portage La Prairie, Manitoba, exclusively on ShawTV and Shaw Direct, channel 299.
Tavern United, a new world sports pub. With a wide selection of sporting events televised at our eight locations in Manitoba. Tavern United, your destination for great sports all the time.
Welcome back to the Canad Inns Destination Center in Portage. Stephen Laycock and his rink from the Nutana Curling Club in Saskatoon lead Kevin Cooey of Calgary, former world champion, by a score of 8-5, playing the eighth end, an $18,000 first place check on the line.
That's a pretty good tick. You play the tick over with the corner guard. It doesn't have very far to go to the boards. It just got to the boards and stopped dead. And so their stone does not go back. It's all acceptable. So Kevin Cooey will try the other side.
Yeah.
Well, and this is basic math for both of the teams. Without those guards up front and now able to peel everything in play, Kevin Cooey going to need a break or two to have a chance for that three that he needs to tie.
Our Mike Valente is standing by. He'll have post-game interviews and we'll have the trophy presentation. Also be a couple of rather large checks handed out by Paul Robson of Canad Inns, and there's a miss.
That guard in the miss puts two on the table, but for Cooey, he needs three to tie. Steve looking for that peel again. Kevin's trying to figure out if he can utilize that stone by the boards at all.
You can't be in and buried, and even if you are, it's
a double.
You can't miss off it.
Yeah. Probably have to guard one more. Well, just guard, try to be put in a spot where it's hard to peel it with the outside. Mine's good.
Mine's fine.
Trying to throw that guard again. Heard Mark say try to put it in a spot where it's difficult to remove with the out turn. If you play the other turn,
yeah,
the risk
so.
Is you come off that one on the outside and maybe leave a guard that is better placed. And so that is why this turn continues to be utilized, the in turn. For the peel.
Easy, clean.
Just clean. Here's Kirk Myers.
Easy. It's okay, it's fine.
Oh,
down to just a handful of rocks now in an 8-5 game.
That?
Well, you don't want to mix up the shot.
See, like, in the background, the children open, and
he misses the double, you freeze
wife of Dave Elias here for the presentation of the trophy to the winner of this game, named in honor of their father and husband, Dave.
And the second from Mark Kennedy.
This one might have to curl a bit. Okay, you're good.
Flashes, get back.
Hit half a stone on the top here. I think we got to commit to that, eh?
Yeah.
Got to hit half a stone. Guys.
Yep.
Whoa.
Clean.
Nice shot. Clean it up good, boys, eh?
Peel from the skip. Steve Laycock with his first stone.
For Kevin Cooey now, needs to put both of his in the house. There is no magic to where you place this stone. You usually have some separation, but really you need a miss by your opponent at this point. So it's just about hitting paint, and he's done that. And now they will sit back and wait for Steve Laycock to throw his final stone.
Last stone for Stephen Laycock. This will do it right here. And it's handshakes all around. Steve Laycock of Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, and his team from the Nutana Curling Club are the champions for 2015 here at the Canadiens Men's Classic, an 8-5 victory over former world champion Kevin Cooey. And Kathy, just maybe a quick comment on what you've seen here.
Well, tonight, the final numbers for Steve Laycock, 97%. Oh. And as a skip, when you shoot 97%, and within that was a shot as good as you are ever going to see, that really fine double weight that led to that three-point advantage, it's pretty tough to beat a team whose skip is at 97%.
Well, the Laycock rink, clearly the class of the field here in Portage this week, running the table with a perfect 7-0 record. We'll be back to hear from them, and we'll have the trophy presentation in just a moment. You're watching the Canadiens Men's Classic from Portage on ShawTV.
Football is live on Shaw. Tune in Friday, October 23rd, when the high-flying UBC Thunderbirds touch down in Saskatoon for a battle with the Saskatchewan Huskies. Crown Produce, Canada West football, only on Shaw.
Shaw TV wants to send two deserving recipients to the 103rd Grey Cup. Do you know a super fan, a football player doing great work in their community, or perhaps a teacher who goes above and beyond for their students? Tell us why this person deserves a pair of tickets to the Grey Cup, and they will be entered to win tickets to the biggest CFL game of the year.
Canad Inns Destination Centers, proud to support our community with 10 destination centers in Manitoba.
Here with the winning skip, Steve Laycock. The shot you guys made to conclude the fifth end there to make it 7-4, those are the types of shots that win championships. How did that feel?
Yeah, it felt great. They had put all their eggs in one basket really there by trying to force us into the skinny double. They're hoping for a flash and a steal or two, or us to not commit to the shot and just give them a steal one. So yeah, once that made contact, it felt really great.
After such a long weekend, what is the message throughout the course of a game like this?
Well, especially when you get up like that, just to stick to your routine. If you start chasing the finish line, you can get in trouble a bit. I think that actually happened to us in one of our rocks in the last end there, where just a slight miss. But just focus on the routine and make sure that you just control what you have control over. If you're waiting for them to miss or for the game to come to a conclusion before it's there, that's not the right focus.
How are you and your team going to celebrate?
By driving home, it's a... We drove here, and we got a long trek back. So
maybe tomorrow something.
Yeah, for sure. Maybe tomorrow we'll go out for some drinks.
Congratulations, Steve. All the best. Let's send it upstairs to Mike and Kathy.
Celebrating with a drive home to Saskatoon. Let's join Paul Robson of Canad Inns now with the trophy and check presentations.
Thank you very much. My name is Paul Robson, CEO of Canad Inns Corporation, and on behalf of Leo Ledahowski, our chairman, and the 3,500 family members at work at Canad Inns, I hope you've enjoyed this tremendous week of curling and more to come this following week. With us tonight are Trent Ward, our general manager of Canad Inns Destination Center, Portage La Prairie, and Sue Elias McKenzie and Nick Elias, who will be presenting the Dave Elias Memorial Trophy. First, I would like to call on Team Coey to receive their checks. Ben Haber, Brent Lang, Mark Kennedy, and Kevin Coey from Glencoe in Calgary, Alberta. Thank you very much, Kevin, for a great evening of curling.
Thanks, Trent. Where do you want us to stand?
Right in front.
Thanks, Trent. Thanks, Trent.
Thanks again, Trent.
Appreciate it.
That was awesome, Trent.
I'd like to now call on Sue Elias with Mackenzie and Nick to present the Dave Elias Memorial Trophy. Canad Inns is proud and delighted to be involved with the Elias family. I know this was one of Dave's favorite events, and we're just delighted to honor him in that way. Let me call on our winners of the 2015 Canad Inns Men's Classic from Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. Dallin Myris, pardon me, Colton Flash, Kirk Myris, and Steve Laycock. Gentlemen, congratulations on a great game. Hope you've enjoyed the week.
Come on in the front there, guys.
It's a big hardware.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thanks. Thank you. Let's get a picture with the trophy there. Get the family in for a picture.
Good morning, guys.
Come on, guys.
Jump in there. Get right in there.
Get in the middle. You get in the middle, buddy. You gotta hold it. Get in there.
Get in there, man.
Wonderful. That's it.
Thanks, man.
You betcha.
good move. Thank you, Kevin.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you, members of your team. We really enjoyed it. And of course, the mixed starts tomorrow, followed by the Women's Canadians Classic. We hope to see you all back here in Portage La Prairie for another exciting week of curling. Thank you very much. Good evening.
There you go, Paul Robson with the trophy presentation. What an incredible weekend of curling. Team Carruthers was defeated, Team Thomas was defeated, and now just Team Cooey. Steve Laycock's team, the champions, they are the winners of the 2015 Canadians Men's Classic. We appreciate you joining us over the course of the weekend. A reminder, we'll be back next weekend for the Women's Classic, Saturday at 5 p.m., Saturday at 8:30 p.m., and then the final match Sunday at 6 p.m. From the Portage Curling Club in Portage La Prairie, this has been the 2015 Canadians Men's Classic on ShawTV.